from your dreams. The power of randomness was celebrated by all. Those with dice would roll them to shape their destinies. And the bravest few would challenge each other in games of chance. Epic tournaments, in which their very lives would hang in the balance. That was in the era of the dice wielders. And like all eras, it too would come to an end, fading into legend and mystery. Our story begins later, in Wancroft, a small village populated entirely by people who have never once been dealt a fair hand.
Attention, Wanners! I am the Queen, and my dark dice will decide your fate.
Random rules!
See that, Bernard? You're a sixer.
Oh, wow! I'm gonna live in the Queen's Dream Palace for the rest of my...
Nuh-uh, you're a dirty three, doomed to a life of fighting and misery.
That's cheating!
Well, so is having an almighty dice, snake eye.
Stop, you guys. Wrap this up. We should really get going.
It's just a game, sis.
Even I promised Mom and Dad to get you home.
The Queen! It's the Queen!
Hey! Was that really necessary?
Come on, hurry up! Now we really have to run!
Odd, wait!
Stay behind me, sis. We've got to run home and hide. Now!
Ooh.
happen to it, sis?
Come on, let's get out of here.
Random rules!
Random rules!
That's Nanny Fortuna. Works for the Queen, kidnapping children for her.
Kidnapping?
And so the Queen decreed that any child who had reached the age of 12 would be given the grand honor of rolling her one true dice, which would reveal to them their place in the world of random.
Check out this secret portal.
Bring me all of the children.
It's an old crawl space.
Nice work, Bernie. Let's go.
For the Queen's wisdom is as wide as her power, which is infinite, which makes it very easy for all of you to do what she says, since she is and ever shall be correct. And though you may feel a twinge of emotion when you watch your children move to their new villages, ensure that you are feeling the correct emotion, which is joy. Joy that the Queen's plan for us is so grand. Joy that her one true dice has deigned to fix the fate of your offspring. And joy, yes, joy.
Even Odd, where have you been? We've been worried sick.
I'm sorry, Dad. I tried to.
There's no time. She'll be here any minute.
Quick, get down.
Happy birthday.
Oh, Even.
And I got a present for you.
It's so cute.
Make a wish.
And the Queen said, every child of 12 years shall throw this supreme dice, and so it was. For random is fair, random prevails, and random rules.
Random rules!
Be grateful, child, that the Queen herself is here for your special day. Now roll the dice, and let's see what kind of person you truly are.
No.
It had been settled.
At least, she'll be a sixer. Stop it!
No, Even.
And so, Odd's destiny came to be living by the side of the Queen up in the Sixer's palace, where, it was said, all dreams came true. But Even's nightmare was just beginning.
I'm coming for you, sis. coming, Odd! Odd!
More than a year had passed since her sister had been taken away from her, and in all that time, Even had never dreamed like that before. Even knew she was now awake, and knew this was the same house she'd lived in, a portrait of Uncle Jinx. A painting of Aunt Cordelia, an image of great great grandfather Peter's, 200 years ago. He ate all his Even's father never told her stories. He preferred reality. Oh, it was still very late. Or was it very early? And Even didn't want to wake her parents. Even's father never told her stories. He preferred reality. These paintings showed stories Even's mother told her were safe to share, because they were true. Well, so the scariest painting Even's mother had ever made was of the Shadow Man, a mysterious figure. Stared at the toy, feeling the ground tilt beneath her. That was the exact same stuffed animal she'd given Odd on the night she was taken. Even knew her parents would be heartbroken when they woke and found her missing. But she had to go. She had to know. Figure seemed to keep its distance from Even. When she got closer, it moved further away. It was leading her somewhere.
Phew! Easy there, Even. What are you doing out so darn late? You're running like the old witch Uma put a curse on you. Oh, darling. You're trying to find your sister, aren't you? I'm afraid the past is the past, child. Ah, that spark in your eye tells me you're not fooling around. I remember being your age once, I do. And I know how important imagination can seem. All right, I'll get out of your way. But don't tell your parents you saw me. Deal? You're quite welcome, young Miss Even. And stay away from the outskirts.
Wait up!
This was Onecroft, the world in which Even and her small family live. Like all Wanners, they haul junk for the cargo ships that came and went in the night. All this labor was done for reasons that were never clearly understood. The Queen willed it, and no one would dare oppose her, and that was enough for everyone. Everyone, that is, except Even.
Come on, Burn, just hit it. It's right there.
He's trying, Lucky.
Aw, shucks. Now I'm all out of potatoes.
Ha! No breakfast tomorrow, and you couldn't hit the spot.
Whoa! Not bad, Even. I knew you could do it.
Lucky shot. I'm not impressed. I could do that too if I wanted. No problem.
That was amazing, Even.
Hey, shut up.
What are you doing here anyway?
Yeah, Even. Are your parents letting you out after dark now? Aw, that's so great. I know after Autumn had to leave, they've been more protective of you, and it's just so great to have you here to play, Even.
At least you're new. These two idiots are getting on my nerves.
Hey, Lucky, that's mean!
Aw, shucks. I know I'm not the smartest, but I try real hard.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Wow, sensitive much? You guys are so touchy.
We're playing.
She was talking to me?
I think she was talking to all of us. Even, we're playing.
We're playing hit the pot with the potato. Or rather, I'm playing. These two bloobs are just losing at it.
I couldn't sleep. My 12th birthday is coming up.
Mine too. Gonna get to roll the dice when it comes. I'm gonna be a sixer. I know it. I'll be saying bye to all you bloobs and hi to the riches of Sixtopia.
I'm not a bloob. I'm a star. My mom says so.
I'm not a bloob either. What's a bloob?
You getting a load of these bloobs, Even? Listen, Even, it takes two to be a jerk. One to be the jerk, and the other to be an even bigger jerk by pointing it out. Well, that's just her bad luck.
Really? How come?
Because my name is Lucky.
He meant how come Even thinks it didn't work out, Lucky?
Oh, that's mysterious. Have fun with your cool mystery, Even. See you later.
You seem like you're looking for something, kid. Ah, I thought I recognized you. Your odd sister, right? Did the big roll a year ago, if I recall. She's in the Queen's care now, kiddo. There's nothing any of us can do. And I think you should give up on her, Even. She's a sixer now. Nobody ever comes back from...
You saw it, didn't you? There it was again.
Come on!
Whatever that spirit wanted. It seemed to involve bringing Even here. But
random
why?
Rules, Even. Random rule.
Big city life. Oh, must be so glamorous to be so cosmopolitan. So two-sided.
That strange figure. Even knew that her fate was changing, that her future was suddenly filled with unknowns, and she also had the distinct feeling that she wouldn't be back home for quite some time. Even could barely make out what the ghostly figure was. It was beautiful, inscrutable, and there seemed to be a sorrow to her. There was no time to think. Even was either going home to her parents without answers, and with even more questions than before, or she was getting on that boat. She felt a pull, beckoning towards something new.
Oh, those are some nice cards you have there, kiddo. You find them yourself? Well, heck, let me take a look. Maybe these old papers will notice something you haven't. Suit yourself, missy. I ain't gonna force you into doing anything you don't want to. Oh, but before you go, a word of warning. Be careful out there, missy. Tonight's the night the junk collectors come. His boat's here. And the guards over there don't let nobody close. The harbor's hiding secrets tonight, missy. Or they load up the boats with junk and take it to other areas of random. Though what for, I can't rightly say. Nobody who knows is willing to say, and nobody else can see for themselves. Everyone just keeps their heads down and does their job. Except for me. I don't do any of it. I'll never work for that rotten queen. Safe travels.
This ain't your home, kid. You don't belong here.
No. You don't get to come here. Smart is a smart. You get your own. Now, go away. Who am I? Who are you barging in here demanding who I am? Oh, I'm even too. Even less interested in letting you in. Now leave! This is Herman's hidey hole. My little stowaway chamber, my realm of adlubescence that you're not invited in. It's my ticket out of this muddy town. I mean something that's delightful. Like my room here, I Wow. You really are just a kid, huh? Well, guess what? I myself was a kid once. Kid Herman. And now I'm adult Herman, and I'm getting out of here. Now go find your own spot. There are no... Come on! There's got to be other spots. Go find them. Oh, for the love of... Fine, you little guilt tripper. I'll let you in. Oh, but before I do, we got ourselves some house rules. One, be quiet. Two, don't touch anything. And three, be quiet and don't touch anything.
The moment she'd let herself think about it, even realized she was actually exhausted. Tonight alone, she'd seen a ghost, run away from home, and boarded a ship traveling somewhere deep into the unknown heart of Random. Would she ever return? It didn't matter. Odd was the only thing that mattered. With her sister's name on her lips, Even fell into a deep slumber.
Hello, Even.
You're home. It's where you belong.
Odd's in trouble. Trouble is Odd.
At least she'll be a sixer.
A oneer is a oneer.
Is a oneer is a oneer.
When you're right, you're right.
Even, come stay with us. Do you want some tea? Everything's better with
tea. Tea fixes everything.
Listen to your mother, Even.
It's a dangerous world.
Listen to your mother, Even.
Stay here. It's safe here. We'll never leave you again. We'll always be here, Even.
You'll always be her, Even.
Her desires are odd.
It's the only way she'll learn.
Go.
The Queen will find you.
To go. I miss my sister. I miss my parents.
My darling, you're safe now. They can't hurt you anymore.
Hurt me? No, that's not right. They never... I don't think they...
They were denying you your future, robbing you of your true destiny. You're finally home.
This whole time ship's falling apart. Today's a difficult day for you, Herman.
Wait! What am I supposed to do?
Take one of these bad boys. Even
lost sight of Herman. She realized she'd also lost sight of her last connection to home.
Okay, still alive. I can work with that. As long as I don't land on water, I should be able to work with that. Find time to remember I don't know how to swim.
She hoped desperately that she'd land somewhere near Sixtown, but the wind and the fates had very different plans for her, indeed.
Ah! Well, where is this place?
She couldn't yet understand it, but Even had landed in the middle of something exceptional. These were the ruins of a time long past, and the magic she could almost sense in the air wasn't about to give up its secrets that easily.
First person to come here in decades.
Thank you.
Are you okay? Are you,
alive!
Okay. Well, thanks for saving me back there. You were really, well, heroic. Right. Okay. Talking to a dice. I better get going. You should too. This place is really dangerous. I guess you can tag along. The more the merrier, right? Okay, Evan, keep it together. Nice! Not a trap. Those are mine. You don't just take things from people. Ugh, fine. You could hold on to them, I guess. Just don't digest them. Too. Yep, they're attacking.
Oh, it was clear that these were no ordinary cards. Dicey was no ordinary dice. Something extraordinary was awakening. Didn't understand what was happening to her and her new dice friend. But she didn't need to. There was another, more obvious truth that she understood completely. She was truly and inarguably kicking robot butt.
Whoa! Dicey! Maybe leave with that.
With each movement, the girl and her dice became more and more inseparable. Dicey were moving as one, an unstoppable fighting machine.
more cards. Oh, I wonder what these do. Listen, we're an incredible team, and as long as I'm going to be talking to you, I should probably know your name. Right. Well, how about if I just call you Dicey? Perfect. Well, let's see if we can find a way out of this place, Dicey.
To the entities that slumbered in this long-forgotten world, even had just become interesting. And that was seldom good. Even and Dicey were moving as one, an unstoppable fighting machine.
Having a headache too. Right, well, we'll have to talk more later, but for now, let's just focus on surviving, yeah? It's like something out of Mum's drawings.
No.